Stephen Licari, what can I do to reduce likelihood of a blood clot? I'm currently taking Plavix. Obviously, watch all the other components of health. That's what we all have to do. Health, strokes, is clotting as we get older, become bigger and bigger issues. As I've described a few times, the biggest item causing clots is something that most of us ignore. You go to the CDC site and look up number of people with prediabetes. They'll tell you that they're aware of at least 80 million Americans. And the bigger thing is, they'll tell you that only 8 million are aware of it. I will tell you that the 80 million is low. Prediabetes helps us, causes inflammation. It causes plaque. Plaque causes inflammation, and inflammation causes clotting. So the most important thing for all of us to do is to be very sure that we know what our glucose metabolism is. Look at our channel. You see it time and time and time again. Hey, doc, I took your studies. I'm not pre-diabetic. I'm full-blown diabetic. And my doctor had no clue. I will say that over and over again. And it's because it's a warning to all of us. I'm not the only person sounding that warning. The CDC sounding it. I mean, just American College of Lifestyle Medicine. Just open your eyes and look. And it also sounds like sometimes I'm criticizing other docs. I'm not. Dr. McCord, he and I've worked together. He can share. He's a great primary care doc. Again, great focus on prevention. And he can tell you that the vast majority of the medical machine is not geared for prevention. And you don't need a doctor to tell you that. Patients tell me that all day, every day. One of the biggest misses of our medical systems has to do with not knowing and understanding prediabetes. Some of my old colleagues, cohort at Hopkins, have done a lot of the world-class research in demonstrating that your typical primary care doctor does not understand prediabetes. And your question is, what can I do to decrease likelihood of clot? Again, pardon me if I've gone down a bunny hole. That's not a bunny hole. That is a gaping chasm that even the CDC knows of 72 million Americans that are falling into that on a regular basis and don't even know. The most important thing I see, and pardon me if I sound like I'm being repetitive, all the other stuff, the supplements, the webinars, the plaque evaluation, all of that is interesting. But the one thing that this channel can accomplish and is geared for in terms of impacting health is helping all these people understand, all these tens of millions of people that have prediabetes and just don't know it. Understand that, because forewarned is forearmed. There is plenty you can do. You can stop the progression of prediabetes and diabetes cold. Stephen, maybe I didn't answer it very clearly. My point was that inflammation is the number one cause of blood clots, number one cause of heart attacks, number one cause of strokes, and by far and away, the number one cause of inflammation is unrecognized prediabetes. So it probably sounded to you, Stephen, like I went off on a bunny hole, into a trail. But if you want to avoid blood clots, the vast majority of blood clots, as in heart attacks and strokes, are caused by prediabetes. So I'll say it again. My major focus would be to recognize whether or not you have prediabetes. That may sound like a totally off-the-wall connection, but I hope this time you can understand the reason for what I'm talking about. Why wait for a disease and hope for a cure? I used to be an ER doc. My name is Ford Brewer. I quit ER after a few years because it was just so frustrating. Most of the things bringing people into the ER are things that should have been prevented, including heart attack, stroke, number one cause of death, number one cause of permanent disability. People think that you're just going to have those and that they're not predictable. Both of those are wrong. They are predictable, and you don't have to have them. Usually it's lifestyle. Lifestyle is more important than supplements and even prescription drugs and even stents and surgery. But the current times are tough. Major financial impact with the lockdowns that most states have been going through. We've been working on a way to make this much more affordable with a subscription process. And that's exactly what we're announcing today. We've got two levels. One is the Silver membership, where you get access to our courses, a private webinar each month, and access to our supplement store and supplement recommendations and prescription. Or I would suggest even more so, the Gold membership. You can get a script for a freestyle Libre and find out what your blood sugar metabolism's doing on a daily basis. And you can get a lab order for inflammation, OGTT, and insulin survey. You can also get a 30-minute one-on-one with me. So I'm looking forward to seeing you. Cost is no longer an excuse. So if you're interested, go to go.prevmedheartrisk.com/prevmed-subscription or call us at 859-721-1414, 859-721-1414, or email us at myhealth@prevmedheartrisk.com. Looking forward to seeing you. Thank you.